with Wayne Kizer. I'm from Harrisburg, Oregon, a co-owner of KB Feed Solutions, along with Nick Bowers. We started the cover crops about 5 years ago, bringing KB Royal back into this area. Over the last 5 years, we've seen the cover crop go from just strictly the progressive no-tiller to almost all the no-tillers to now we're bringing into the conventional farming community. Huge amount of interest. I keep asking people, why are you now looking at cover crops? They said our neighbor's using cover crops. Their field looks better than mine. I better find out what he's doing. So it's been a big growth here lately. Your ryegrass is great to do with a whole lot of mixes. Probably the two most popular ones is mixing it with either some sort of cover crop radish or either the crimson clover, either one. They both have their benefits and advantages to it. If you're aerial applying a radish crop, you're going to have to be getting up into some pretty high poundages and pretty expensive mixes. The annual ryegrass allows you to cut back on your radish down to 4 or 5 pounds rather than 10 or 15, so you're saving $20 an acre right there. Plus, having those both crops in there, the radishes will die out in the winter. Most of your soil erosion and nitrogen losses are going to happen in the spring. The annual ryegrass will continue to hang on to that. You can kill it out and have it for you next summer. The number one fear with annual ryegrass is I can't kill the darn stuff. And our response to that is yes, you can kill it. You just have to do it right. What we found out is when Nick and I came out here, we heard you can't kill it with Roundup. Well, yeah, you can. But farmers out here are just like farmers in Oregon. We're an impatient group of people. And when that sun comes out on that nice spring day, we want to do something. And I understand that. Just don't try to kill your annual ryegrass. Because after your normal winter, which I don't count this winter to be normal, but after your normal winter, you're going to have a small amount of green growth in your annual ryegrass. You're going to have 3 or 4 feet of good, solid roots down below. You cannot get enough Roundup on an 1.5-inch plant to kill 4 feet of roots. You do put enough to make it go into a chemical dormancy. You go out 2 weeks later and you say, hey, the stuff is still green, you spray it again. Now it's in that chemical dormancy, it doesn't absorb the ryegrass. And then my phone starts ringing, hey, you've got resistant ryegrass or I can't kill your ryegrass. It's not resistant, you've just made it mad and it's angry. And it's stuck in its dormancy. Allow the temperature to warm up, allow that material to get up there, the annual ryegrass to get 6 to 9 inches tall. On a 50 degree day when it starts to warm up and it's growing actively, then go ahead with a good rate of Roundup, 4.5, in a buffered spray solution. I like to throw a little phenoxys in it. Then get good coverage spraying during the first half of the day while the temperature is going up. Once the temperature starts to drop down, park the sprayer and be done. But you can kill it. And I've got a lot of guys that are waiting until the day they plant. Maybe the day before, they spray the field, they plant it while it's still green and standing up. It's a lot easier to run the planter through. And it works well for them. Then it falls down, gets them good weeds